Good evening. I'm sure we can do better than that. It's a nice crisp evening. So I'm going to try that again. Let's see if I can get a better response. Good evening.
Good evening.
So much better. So what I'm going to ask you to do is imagine yourself in this space. Okay? Now what I want you to do is close your eyes and imagine yourself in this space. You walk into a dimly lit room and you see a few old rags of clothes on a wall, on a gray stone wall. You look in the other corner and you see a broken commode. The only thing that you can hear is tick tock of a clock on the wall. The friends that have walked in with you are equally lost and suddenly realize that you are in a prison. The door behind you shuts and you are locked into the space. And you hear a voice tell you, you only have 60 minutes and your time starts now. Your friends and you start running around in a frenzy, examining the room to see what is it that can help you. Something, anything that can help you escape out of that space. You suddenly realize that there are a few hidden clues and codes written on the wall and the unassuming items that are lying around. You manage to crack the first clue and you feel victorious. And that's when the chain begins. One clue leads to another, and you finally completed level one. Level two seems a little more difficult. You are completely relying on your friends to solve it, only to realize that they have laid their hopes on you. You realize that you only have 5 minutes and you still have the final clue to try and get out of that space. There is a lot of pressure that is building on. There is an intense discussion. All the team members are trying desperately to figure out what is the 4-digit exit code to get you out of that room. But that lock will just not budge. Now it is your turn. You only have 2 minutes to go. Either you can win or the clock will win. Either you can make sure your team wins or you lose. With 2 minutes to go, you have one final attempt at that lock. You manage to, with your intellect, decipher that clue. You punch it into the keypad and the door opens. It's victory. Only for you to realize that all of this that you did was completely in a game and the reality is in front of you. But the team is actually celebrating. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you to open your eyes at this moment. What you have just experienced is what an escape game feels like. It's fun. It's intellectual. It is an activity that you do along with your team members. And when you achieve or when you are victorious, it leaves the team members feeling high. It is this feeling of achievement that bonds teams together. And that is what makes escape rooms or escape games the employee retention strategy of the future. Escape games are a live game. They're not really played on a computer or on a laptop. We even lock away the players' mobile phones. Okay, I'm sure a lot of you are wondering why was your mobile phone taken. But an escape game is a live game where you get to experience these very different real-life scenarios along with your team. And trust me, these scenarios are not something that you live in a regular life. It could be something right from you trying to solve a murder mystery where you get into a room as a detective and you try and solve clues and codes, crack the crime to figure out who the killer is. Or it could be something where you get to, you know, perform a bank heist. We have players that have got carried away so much that there was this one female who was trying to, you know, escape out of a prison. She took it so seriously that she picked up a hammer and she started breaking down the wall. And we've, you know, just by the way, if you are working or if you are trying, you're in an escape game, if you perform a bank heist, does not mean that you can take the hall, put it in your pocket and walk away. So that's not how it works. So what exactly is an escape game? To put it in very simple words, you get locked into a room with your group of people, with your team, and you only have 60 minutes to escape without the use of computers, laptops or your mobile phones. It's all there. It's real. You're locked into a room and you have 60 minutes to escape. And how do you do that? You do that by solving clues, codes and puzzles. Do you know why escape games are making their way into the future of workspaces? It's because the stress induced in a game eventually leads to happiness. Confused? or surprised at a statement like that. Stress, you know, induces happiness. Well, let me explain that to you. Happiness is actually an emotional state which gets triggered by releasing or by release of certain body hormones. Are there anybody in this, arena over here who know which those hormones are? Is there anyone know which hormones trigger happiness? Can I just see a show of hands? Okay, so we have a couple of you guys. That's great. So for all you others, let me tell you, there are four hormones which are used for triggering happiness. Endorphins, dopamine, you have serotonin, and you have oxytocin. Now the first hormone, endorphin, gets released when we do some sort of a physical activity. So when you go for your morning walks, or even when you go to the gym, or even something as simple as when you laugh, the body releases an endorphin to help you cope with the physical stress. Endorphins are one of the key reasons for creating happiness. So I'm going to tell you how that works. So we're going to do a little activity. What I want you to do is I'm going to ask you to clap. Okay? But there are three simple rules to the clap. A is that you have to clap faster than your neighbor. B, you have to clap louder than your neighbor. And the third rule is that you have to make a lot of hooting noise. Okay? And when I think you've done that fair enough for 5 seconds, I'll ask you to stop. Okay? So we're going to start. Start clapping louder, faster, and make hooting noises. Super. Thank you so much. Aren't you a little happier you did that now? Don't you feel a little more energized? That's what endorphins do. So when players enter escape games, the first thing that they do along with their teammates is start looking around the room. They're looking at the walls. They're examining all the furniture that is there. They are looking at all possible locks that are there in the room. They run around in such a huge frenzy. At times, they look like headless chickens. I have, till date, never seen a player who's probably sat down and relaxed in an escape game. So, in this rapid movement, the body looks at it as an exercise in an escape game, and so endorphins are released in escape games. That is a team's first instance of happiness. The second one is dopamine. Dopamine is a hormone that gets released when we achieve a task in our life. It could be something from as simple as probably buying a house, buying a car, or something as simple as opening a stuck-up jar. Once you have that sense of achievement, there is a hormone released to make you feel happy about yourself. So we're going to try that again. What I want you to do is I want you to think of the last task that you completed that you were very happy about. Just take a moment to think and think of the last task that you completed that you were very proud of yourself for achieving. Do we have a few smiles on the face? Would you feel happy about yourself for achieving that? And that's what dopamine does. In escape games, what happens is that when players are in the game, the brain does not understand the difference between real life and a game. So the brain is telling the body that at particular moment, at that particular time, your biggest task is to escape out of that room, and that will be your biggest achievement. So every single time someone cracks a code or they manage to open a lock, the body releases dopamine to give people happiness. Dopamine is probably the biggest reason why a lot of married men are still on shadi.com. Because whenever someone expresses interest, they are super proud of themselves. So that's dopamine over there. Now the third hormone, serotonin, is released in a very peculiar moment in our life. Serotonin is released when we act in a way that benefits others. So when you basically reach out or help out someone else, or even a simple task is when you give back to the nature, serotonin gets released for you to feel happy about yourself. So what I want you to do is I just want you to look at your neighbor, either on your right or left, and thank them. Say, thank you for making my evening so special. Just look at your right or left and say, thank you for making my evening so special. Did you know that a little bit of serotonin gets released even every single time you recommend a movie to a friend or you even recommend a restaurant? Also, every single time you like someone's face, post on Facebook, there is a small level of serotonin that gets released. So next time your spouse complains that you're spending way too much time on social media, tell them, you know what, it's not me, it's serotonin. So what happens in an escape game is when you help a team member decipher a certain part of the clue, you feel happy about it. That's because the hormone gets released. So the way it works in an escape game is when you crack a clue on yourself, there's dopamine that's released. And then when you help a team member, there's serotonin that's released. Isn't that a nice win-win situation? And when all of this happens, you know, when people crack clues or they help each other, we have seen people pat each other at the back. There are a few high fives that get exchanged. The over-enthusiastic kinds actually hug each other. Basically, when human beings interact with another human being or they get closer to another human being, there is a hormone release that is called oxytocin. So what I want you to do is give a high five to your neighbor and say, this was awesome. Now turn to the other side and give a high five to the other neighbor.
Awesome.
So what you're doing is that once you give a high five to yourself, when you're giving a high five to your neighbor, there is a small release of oxytocin that happens. In a more everyday way to explain this to you, this is the reason why we probably hug a loved one, or this is the reason why we hug our family members, or even someone who is sad is the reason why we shake hands with a stranger, or why we put a, you know, arm around the shoulder of a buddy. In short, the jadoo ki jappi works. And we have seen a lot of our players go through these emotions. What happens at escape games is that because of this emotional interaction that happens, team members tend to connect with each other at an emotional ground, which in turn leads to long-term relationships, building long-term strong relationships. But a key question here is that why don't these teams act in the same way when they are faced with a pressure situation at work or when they are faced with a tight deadline at work? It's because these teams are not used to working under pressure with each other. That's why they crack. More often than not, they crack under pressure. But what happens at an escape game is that these teams are working together under a lot of stress and pressure of the clock ticking, but they're doing a fun activity. So what happens in turn is that the team members identify their collective strengths. They also tend to rely and trust each other, which in turn brings them closer, bonds them better. Escape games are the future of team bonding and employee engagement. In fact, a lot of multinational companies and corporates now have a mandate which says that if there is an escape game available in your city, the team should do that activity once in every 6 months. Escape games are in fact making their way into the future workspaces. Just think about it. You have a new team of recruits that you need to orient, you know, to your company core values. The future induction centers in these companies are going to be escape games that are incorporated with the company values built into clues and codes. You have a team that is majorly stuck up and they cannot arrive at a solution. It's not going to be the coffee breaks or the late nighters with pizza, but it's going to be escape pods where the team can go and get energized and refocused. You have a new product you want your team to get excited about. It's going to be the launch booths or escape booths that are going to help them discover what the product is. Escape games are making their way into future workspaces as the solution for bringing teams together so that they stay with the company. Together, today, when we are creating the future of work or the future of workspaces, let's add in a little bit of life into these spaces for our people, for our employees, by giving them small but regular doses of happy hormones. Let's make life happy at work. Good evening, and thank you so much. Thank you.